Hello and welcome to Meet the Boss TV. In this program, your application support and maintenance costs are rising, but is the solution brains or bodies? Application support and maintenance costs people, time and money. According to Gartner, ASM accounts for 38% of large organizations' overall IT budget each year, with 83% of those surveyed stating that the cost of maintaining and supporting applications is increasing. Clearly, the system doesn't work. So how can we fix it? IT and software development giant HCL surveyed 300 global organizations to get to the heart of the problems being faced by CIOs and ASM. Later, I'll be speaking with Mark Swain about the company's alternative approach. But first, those results.
The key findings of the survey were not entirely surprising. The CIO is needing to invest in new technologies, but having the budgets constrained to the previous years, if not less, and therefore needing to release capital out of the legacy estate and retire and simplify the legacy estate. Now, that being the overall driver, the next findings were probably sort of supportive of that. When they've looked at their estates, they've discovered that a huge percentage of the IT budget is tied up in that old legacy. The old legacy itself is not very agile, and in fact, it's just growing. So as all these new applications are coming on board, and the application count is going higher and higher, and the CIO is faced with the very difficult task of trying to release capital out the legacy and shifting it to the front end. We also discovered that there's a lot of disappointment around the value that service providers had created over the last 10 years or so in outsourced contracts. There's a sense of disappointment that many people had used the term transformation very liberally, and in fact had just delivered basic cost arbitrage. And the organizations today still have the very complex legacy applications, loads of duplication supporting duplicate business processes, and no simplification, no agility, no transformation to be seen of other than cost reduction, cost reduction, cost reduction.
So you guys are taking an alternative approach to ASM. Maybe you could outline the key pillars of that approach.
I think the genesis of alternative ASM was actually a recognition by HCL that when we look back over the last 10 years of what we call Indian-based outsourcing, we recognized that many customers had, fallen into a bit of a trap around the concept of what transformation truly was. Many customers signed up to contracts which used the term transformation, partnership, etc. The idea being that the IT service providers would work strongly to actually simplify application environments, infrastructure environments, retire applications, and generally make things more streamlined in IT operations. We believe that what in truth has really happened is that customers have been received massive cost savings, for example, from offshoring, outsourcing, and that concept of transformation was only one in the cost base and simply obtained by labor arbitrage. Secondly, their processes haven't really been improved. In other words, IT outsource providers are still using the same processes, maybe marginally altered to the ones that they inherited. Thirdly, that the productivity claims that are being shopped around are actually not proper productivity. So by this, I mean as follows. We typically take quite a big saving by moving a service to a low-cost country, up to order of magnitude 20-25%. We then are able to do on the face of it, the job with fewer people. If you look at the working hours in India, for example, you get a 9-hour day versus a Western 8-hour day, a 12.5% difference over a week. Now, is that true productivity? At HCL, we don't think it is. We think that it's just part of the right-sizing, right-shoring that goes with application support and maintenance. What we brought to the table beyond that, though, is a very, very sort of scientific approach to analyzing the data that customers give us around the application estate. So obviously that presupposes that you do have an application estate inventory, that you are gathering data around your applications, and that you're able to then make sense of that data. Now, unfortunately, we also discover that those first two assumptions are incorrect. Many customers don't know what applications they've got.
Okay, sure. So this is all about that age-old business problem, getting visibility into your organization.
Absolutely. So when we go back to these two points, we find that we can work with customers to understand what applications they've got. Simple mapping exercises, graphical tools are used. We're able to map processes and businesses and spot duplication. The second point is to help them understand how they can gather data. It's actually very simple. From the point we start engaging with them, we encourage them to start capturing incident and problem data, service request data. Anything will do to start, but the more details you capture, the more chance you've got at actually driving some productivity improvements. Now, when you've got that data, we're typically able to then start to map, for example, incident data, problem data, service request data to industry-specific benchmarks that we've developed for our clients. Now, that's a very important point. We find that when we work around any service request or incident catalog, we find that actually they are very specific to the industries that we work in. It seems obvious, but actually we find our competitors don't actually look at it like that, and they tend to try and deal with all incidents as if they're the same across any company, any technology. We find that by actually looking at it incident-wise and service request-wise by industry, we're able to develop very, very specific solutions, automations for that industry, for that customer that drive productivity improvements. Now, once we've done the analysis, we're able to propose to our clients what their right-sized organization should look like from a headcount perspective and a cost perspective. We're able then to able to articulate what levers we can pull over a 2 to 5 year period to drive further productivity improvements. We're able to take that analysis that we've done, sign up to it contractually, and actually charge customers based on that performance. We take the risk as opposed to charging time and materials, which a lot of people have sort of defaulted towards, and we're very, very clear on what good productivity is and what success looks like. That, I think, sums up the spirit of alternative ASM.
Okay, sure. You have an extensive client list. Could you maybe give us some examples of how this approach has benefited your clients? What challenges did they face, and how did you help overcome those challenges?
Certainly. So I'll use the example of a major German bank based in Germany, a multinational company, one of our largest customers. We started on the journey of application support maintenance then for some years ago now. And over that period, we've radically improved productivity and traced productivity in the application support and maintenance area. We have stimulated those productivity improvements by introducing the concept of a value portal. HCL has been one of the prime movers of this concept of bringing value from employees to the customer by just simply asking employees what they would do differently. Now, those value portals are available for the customers to actually track and audit. We've signed up contractually to driving savings on an annual basis in terms of cost outtake or productivity improvements, and we've been able to demonstrate that year-on-year savings have been achieved.
Okay, sure. So that's less of a traditional vendor customer relationship and more of a partnership approach.
There's a couple of things that HCL do differently to our competitors as well. The first is our sort of employee culture. It goes under the banner, I think it's very well publicized now, of employees first, customer second. Let's be absolutely clear, from an employee's perspective, it's customer first, but from a manager's perspective, it's employees first. Now, the idea of that employees first mantra is that we recognized at least 7-8 years ago that the ability of our employees to drive a value for our customers was based on their ability to be confident, to be able to contribute, and have an opinion. Say no when it counted, and say yes when it mattered. And very fortunately, that allows our employees to actually operate through mechanisms that we call value portals. And we actually, on top of our AltSM proposals or propositions, we create the concept of a value portal where our employees working on a client side, working on systems, are able to contribute continuously with ideas on how they can improve their job, their little area of a process, or even a big area of a process. And we work with customers to quantify the value of those and create small projects and programs to continually improve the environment over the longer term. And we again are able to contractually commit to those changes and cost savings generated through that value regime over a support contract.
Sure. So what impact has this approach had on metrics such as, first of all, employee retention and staff morale, and secondly, customer satisfaction?
Well, starting with the employees first in this space, employees really love being able to contribute, particularly when you've set up an organization which is actually aimed at driving a very sort of factory-driven model. You've got to create some level of interest for the employee if they're doing a repetitive, monotonous job, And we find that actually the ability of allowing our employees to contribute and to drive change radically helps us in terms of retention rates. From a customer perspective, they love the fact that there's a feeling of a partner out there that's actually doing something other than just doing the bare minimum to run their organization, bringing the ideas, making change happen, getting rid of applications, pushing them hard to make the changes themselves, and generally helping drive them in the right direction. They love that.
For more fantastic interviews directly related to your business, be sure to explore Meet the Boss TV.